Hello, boys and girls, and all children of God. Mrs. Toni here, and I brought my Whirl Story Bible. Thank you so much for turning this on today and listening to yet another Bible story that I love to read to you. Today, this is the Sunday, one of the Sundays, it's a long season, after Pentecost, where we're thinking about the Holy Spirit, thinking about God's love and our love, and it's a Sunday talking about little things that grow big. And a story today is called Small But Mighty, and it appears on page 498. And I like to imagine that we are all, no matter what age we are growing in our faith. Children are almost like seeds. They're literally growing physically, growing in their knowledge, growing in their faith. But even us adults are growing and learning in our faith. Let's hear all about Small But Mighty. Some of the early believers were arguing, "I don't want to share with you. That's mine. Give it back. You're not my friend. Go away." One of Jesus' followers heard about these arguments. He wondered why believers spoke such hurtful words. He decided to write a letter to the people in the early church. "Dear friends, be careful what you say to each other. Your tongue is small, but your words can be loud. Don't be unkind. Don't tell lies. Small words can make a big difference. When you ride a horse, you put a bit in its mouth. The bit is small, but it makes the horse go right or left or stop. Your tongue is small, but it can be mean or kind or quiet. You can use your tongue to say good things or bad things. Choose good. Tell about Jesus' miracles. Share his teachings. Praise God. Use kind words, not cruel ones. Talk about love, not hate. If you are unkind, say, 'I'm sorry.' Everyone makes mistakes. Everyone says the wrong thing sometimes. God forgives. Your tongue is small, but it has a big job. Use your words to spread love and kindness to all God's people. Signed, a follower of Jesus." And here's our little Otto saying, "Now, if anyone says I talk too much, I'll tell them I have a small tongue with a big job." Can you believe some people say, "I talk too much"? Well, actually, if you know me, you know that's maybe true. I do talk too much, and I have to think. I have one little mouth, two little ears. I'll have to try to listen two times as much as I talk. Because that way I'll learn a lot, and I'll give other people a turn. And then when I open my mouth and talk, I want to say kind things, good things. I want you to also. And God knows we're going to mess up sometimes. All people do. And then we'll say, "I'm sorry," and we know we can make it better. Now let's sing about being kind together. Let's get our little bee hands up there, and let's try to remember that every day, to be kind. Be kind one unto another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake has forgiven you. Do, do. Doodly-doo, Ephesians 4:32. Hey, you can look that up. Be kind one unto another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God for Christ's sake has forgiven you. Doo-doo, doodly-doo, Ephesians 4:32. Now, fold your hands and pray after me. Dear God, thank you for loving us always. Thank you for forgiving us. when we mess up. And help us to always remember that our little tongues have a big job to spread joy and news of you in the world. Amen.